Did you ever feel excluded other than this exercise?
Yeah.
Yes. Anybody? Yeah, please.
Yes, I did feel.
How? What was it? This is a very good observation, yeah. Please.
I generally do say.
Thoda louder.
मुझे आमतौर पे ये महसूस होता है कि लोग स्टीरियोटाइप भूल गए कि लोगों से बात करने या इंटरेक्ट करने हैं।
This is because of your appearance.
आज सुबह because of my views, because I am tending left in most of the matters generally prevailing in our society, people generally marginalized leftist views.
Okay. Anybody else? जी
सो आई वाज इन अ ग्रुप ऑफ 10 फ्रेंड्स एंड दे वर फ्रॉम केपीके दे वर स्पीकिंग पश्तो सो आई फेल्ट रियली एक्सक्लूडेड
यू फेल्ट एक्सक्लूडेड यस एनीबॉडी एल्स
सॉरी आई वाज इन सुपरवाइजर एक्चुअली एंड आई वाज विद द हेड ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग सो आई वाज टॉकिंग टू हिम एक्चुअली टॉकिंग अबाउट टेक्निकल टर्म्स ऑफ अ ट्रेलर एंड ही वाज लाइक Okay. Where is your CEO? So it.
Okay. A personal example, but this was an easier question. Here is a more difficult question. Did you ever exclude anyone?
Yes.
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 Any examples?
Not intensely. But sometimes.
To be very honest, I was the one who excluded a friend of mine once because I did not feel really same with that person. Because I used to feel just the ideas काफी अलग थी. So I used to be a rigid person earlier. तो मैं exclude कर लेती थी किसी को.
Any other example? जी.
Sir, I always feel that yellow fishes want to interact with me, but there is definitely a hand.
No, the question is if you ever excluded anyone.
Yes, वो एक है बंदा वो.
Okay. आपको एक कार्ड दिया गया था जो आपने लगाना था. You had some people have this card, but I noticed that most of the people did not put the reason for exclusion. There is a question, but nobody responded to that question. I feel that most of the people have a bit of understanding of exclusion or inclusion at the personal level, but on bigger social or national level, we have little understanding of exclusion. So we'll talk about it. Do you think this place is inclusive?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
How do you say that?
The interaction we all have with each other, it's a networking session, so it is inclusive, it's not excluded. You can go to anyone, you can talk to anyone, and they'll talk to you.
Within
and most importantly, anybody is invited. I mean, yes. So Creative Mornings, it's not a you know, like restriction that you can't come to this kind of people.
Do we have any illiterate person here?
So who do you call?
कोई अनपढ़ बंदा बैठा हुआ है यहाँ? Any person, any liberal?
What's your?
I can give you so many names of so many groups which are not represented here. So I'm declaring this place as an inclusive place. There is a question mark.
Definition.
I mean, illiterate. इलेक्ट्रेट और अनपढ़ की भी डेफिनेशन करने की जरूरत है यार. माय पॉइंट इज दैट ऑल द पीपल सिटिंग हियर बिलोंग टू अ सर्टेन क्लास.
यस यस.
एम आई राइट?
यस यस.
सो देन देयर आर अदर क्लासेस व्हिच आर नॉट रिप्रेजेंटेड हियर, व्हिच मींस सम पीपल मे बी अ लार्जर नंबर ऑफ पीपल आर एक्सक्लूडेड. ठीक है. इफ यू डोंट नो इंग्लिश you won't feel included in this group. ऐसा है? होगा ना? तो ये चीजें हम आगे चलते हैं. examples jo maine yahan note ye I'm not talking about this place now, I'm generally talking about our society in which these are some of the groups which are excluded usually. Religious minorities, hamare hum apne Pakistan ki baat karte hain. The first time I realized that we exclude religious minorities was when we were in a protest rally, and there were so many Christians in the rally, there were some Hindus, there were some other the people from other religions, and all the time we Muslims were shouting this slogan, Nara Takbir. And I noticed that all the Christians would be quiet, all the Hindus would be quiet. So, I mean, we didn't have an inclusive slogan for us.
Yeah.
So then I went to the organizers and I asked them, please shout this other slogan, Pakistan Zindabad. So when we said Pakistan, so everybody said Zindabad. This is an inclusive slogan for us. Persons with disabilities, I don't think I need to explain it. Most of our buildings don't have ramps. Most of our buildings are not supportive or and good for persons with disabilities. I personally know somebody who was given an award for his services to people with disabilities. He had established a really good organization in a remote place, and he was invited to an award ceremony, but the PNCA did not have ramps, so he could not go up to the stage and receive his award. This was the irony. Ethnic minorities, or ye bhi hota hai ki bahut sare usme jaise Punjab mein aap ho to Pathan would be excluded.
No sir.
Or agar aap इस पे थोड़ी सी और आगे चल के बात करेंगे, ठीक है? Elderly people, ठीक है? Children, people from lower social strata, women are excluded at so many forums. Particularly आजकल तो आप बहुत आपकी कैबिनेट में औरतें बहुत कम हैं. आपकी जो एडवाइजरी काउंसिल्स बन रही है, गवर्नमेंट की जितनी चीजें बन रही हैं, मुख्तलिफ फोरम्स बन रही हैं, उनमें विमेन रिप्रेजेंटेशन हैज सडनली गॉन डाउन सिंस दिस न्यू गवर्नमेंट. दिस इज अ डेफिनेशन, वी शुड लुक एट इट क्विकली. टू एम्ब्रेस ऑल पीपल इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ रेस, जेंडर, डिसेबिलिटी, क्लास इज द वर्ड दैट आई एडेड बिकॉज इट वॉज नॉट देयर. मेडिकल अदर नीड, इट इज अबाउट गिविंग इक्वल एक्सेस एंड अपॉर्चुनिटीज एंड गेटिंग रिड ऑफ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन एंड इनटॉलरेंस. Conscious exclusion versus unconscious exclusion. Conscious exclusion is often linked to vested interests. Pakistan mein se, I'm trying to give you a few examples. East Pakistan people were excluded from jobs, from army, from so many other forums. Their representation at the national level, they made up 55% of Pakistan's population, but they were forced to have equal number of seats in the national parliament. उर्दू स्पीकिंग वर्सेस हिंदी स्पीकिंग, सेक्टेरियनिज्म, एथनिक डिसकंटेंट, एंटी वुमेन लेजिस्लेशन ऑफ ज़िया इरा दैट एक्सक्लूडेड वुमेन फ्रॉम सो मेनी फोरम्स, एंटी अहमदी लेजिस्लेशन ऑफ भुट्टो एंड ज़िया इरा, वी हैव अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट दैट डिक्लेयर्स समबडी नॉन मुस्लिम. रिलीजन इज यूजुअली नॉट द बिजनेस ऑफ द स्टेट. दीज आर कॉन्शियस एक्सक्लूजन्स. वी मेड लॉज, we made constitutional amendments, we made efforts, conscious efforts to exclude these groups. Unconscious exclusions are usually at personal level. Biases, stereotypes, opinions, judgments, these cause exclusion at the personal level. By the way, aap log sab mujhe dekh rahe hain, koi banda guess kar sakta hai ki main Pakistan ke kaun se ilake se hoon? Any guess?
Dekhne mein.
Okay. और कोई?
लाहौर.
ओके. आई बिलोंग टू कोहाट, आई एम पख्तून. व्हाट डू यू बिलीव दिस? सो दीज आर पर्सनल. समबडी सेड दैट इन पंजाब पख्तूनज आर वेलकम. Punjabis often, my Punjabi friends would often say that you are included, we are so inclusive, we always welcome you in our groups. And I always tell them that it's not because you are so inclusive, It's because I have adopted your culture. मैं एडी चंगी पंजाबी बोलना कि वो मेरे बाहर कट ही नहीं सकते उसे। और जे किसी ने मेरी पंजाबी सुन के हैरत हुई है तो उन्होंने मैं ये भी दस दिया कि मैं तो पख्तून डे रखा रजी अगर कि गुजारा ना तो डे रखा सफा को कुछ लोग उर्दू स्पीकिंग भी समझ लेते हैं बिल्कुल अच्छा स्टीरियोटाइप्स की एक अच्छा एक तो मैं इन पे सोच रहा था कि अपनी पर्सनल लाइफ में से ये स्टीरियोटाइप्स है ना पख्तूनों के बारे में कि वो गोरा चिट्टा होगा वो उसकी उर्दू ठीक नहीं होगी उसके वो पंजाबी तो बिल्कुल नहीं आती होगी तो ये बेसिकली स्टीरियोटाइप्स काज एक्सक्लूजन मैं अपना पर्सनल एक लाइफ इंसिडेंट सुना रहा हूँ एक दफा आई हैड देयर आर सम फॉरेनर्स सो आई स्विच टू इंग्लिश अगेन आई वाज गोइंग टू आई वाज forced to go to attend a meeting in Lahore. I was alone in my own car. I left for Lahore and I was really not happy about it. When I was getting onto motorway, a policeman stopped me and asked me to drop him at Kalkahar. I said, okay. I was alone, so I gave him, I invited him. On the way, by chance, the moment he entered my car, a Punjabi song was playing in my car. It was a long song, Challa, somebody might have heard. When it ended, the next song was Pashto song. Now this man looked at me and said, you hear Pashto songs? I was like, this is a Punjabi guy. And he can't hear Pashto song, I mean this. But this was my assumption, okay? In just a few minutes later, his phone buzzed, he picked his phone and said, Sangha Chalda Ji! So he was Pakhtun. So these stereotypes make us, force us to make judgments, assumptions about others, which is not good. I mean, keep reminding me about time by the way. Barriers to inclusion, physical barriers, inaccessible buildings, especially for persons with disabilities, this example can be very clear. There are other mobility issues, like in rural areas and other areas, these buses or public transport is not available. Even in Islamabad, public transport is not available. So if you don't own a car, you can't go up around the city. You can't join so many forums. About myself, I say if I didn't have a car, I wouldn't have been able to do theater. Because I have to go to Banigala every day to do rehearsals. And that's not possible if I don't own my personal car. Social barriers, stereotypes, biases, we have already talked about it. Financial barriers make it financially inaccessible. Elite class always does this. They make things expensive. They would come up with something new, which is more expensive, so all the other people would be excluded. Political barriers, we have already talked about the amendments in the laws and etc. which create barriers. Like people are not allowed to participate in political activity, voting, candidature, legal documents. I hope you people know that in Pakistan, a non-Muslim cannot become a president of Pakistan, a non-Muslim cannot become a prime minister of Pakistan. So these are political exclusions, barriers. Advantages of inclusion, society becomes more coherent, it becomes peaceful because everybody is included, everybody is heard. Diversity becomes a strength, people stand united. And in this situation, in these circumstances, development and progress is definitely going to investment, business, jobs. These are related to peace. In fact, about Pakistan, I often say that if our government makes just one, makes sure that Pakistan is peaceful, nobody carries weapons, no bombs, no blasts, no murders, Pakistan would prosper. People of Pakistan can do wonders. They would do business, they would bring in so many new things. And you have seen this in the last 4 or 5 years. If you compare Pakistan's situation with 2011 or 12, you see that the security situation has improved a lot, and with that you would see that a lot of activities are going on in Pakistan. In Islamabad, just yesterday I looked at the Facebook of for the events happening in next 4 or 5 days, there were, I counted up to 47. That's huge number of events. People often said Islamabad is a sleeping city, nothing happens in this city. And now there are so many events happening that you can't pick and choose. Disadvantages of exclusion, fragmented society, further fragmentation goes on, like we have already lost East Pakistan, which became Bangladesh in 1971. Lack of trust among various segments of the society. Christians don't trust Muslims, Pashtuns don't trust Sindhis, kind of thing. Lack of coordination within the society, no peace, and the resultant problems like no investment, no business, no employment, no development, no contribution from excluded groups. All the groups that you exclude, they cannot contribute to the national development. Inclusion, how? These are some important points. It starts from education. Talking about both national level, social level and personal level. It starts from education, make your schools accessible to all, review your syllabus, remove stereotypes and biases from syllabus, educate your teachers on inclusion, inclusive design of school buildings, etc. Manage your media. Your media is also playing role in exclusion. Change discriminatory laws. PWDs, women, religious minorities. Equitable distribution of resources. NFC award. Does anybody know what's NFC award?
No, what is it?
Please.
National Finance Commission Award. National Finance Commission. Which,
what's its significance?
Its significance is that it divides the national revenue between provinces
and the federal government. Administrated
areas and the federation.
Yeah, so that's the significance of NFC award. It is how we at the national level distribute resources among provinces and the federal government. So that distribution should be equitable. Empower communities, local government system is something that brings inclusiveness, because there at the local level people are able to reach out to the government and the local councillors, they can reach out to different segments of the society. If you don't have a local government system, so many smaller segments of the society would feel excluded. Implement all the basic rights enshrined in the Constitution, Chapter 1, Clause 8 to 28. Positive discrimination, support underrepresented groups, quota system. Promote arts and cultural activities. I emphasize this so much because I believe when Mehdi Hassan is singing, nobody bothers that the person, whether the person sitting next to me is Shia, Christian, or any other, or from any other religion, or from any other ethnic group. Everybody enjoys music, everybody enjoys theater, everybody enjoys whatever art form is being performed before you. So the more you invest in arts and cultural activities, the more inclusive your society becomes. On personal level, identify, understand, and acknowledge your biases. Biases are untested opinions. Ye Punjabi ride I have already told you. Play about Christian beggar. That's another story from my personal life. हमने minority days पे एक play करना था और उसमें हुआ ये कि again sorry we were doing a big event on minorities day and I wrote a script, a play, street theater. And that play showed a Christian woman begging on the streets. Now in the audience there were some 300 Christian men and women sitting, and they were all up in arms protesting. Did you ever see a Christian begging on the streets? And that was the first time I realized in my life that I never saw a Christian begging on the streets. So I had to apologize to the crowd and I changed the script of them. So it's important that we interact with these segments, different segments of the society, different groups of the society. In the same event, there's another Christian guy who insisted on feeding me. And I was really surprised because I had, in my speech to the crowd, I had said that I welcome all the groups. and I'm not bothered. I don't exclude people from my friends on the basis of their color or religion or anything. And now this person who played tabla, he came to me and he said, let's have lunch together. Now if you know the plight of Christians in Pakistan, the local Christians, I'm not talking about the foreigners who live in Pakistan, the local Christians, nobody wants to share a plate or a dining table with them. So later I realized that this person was actually testing my claim that I had made earlier. Because I didn't want to eat, but it was not because he was Christian and I didn't want to eat with him. I had my own reasons. The food was too spicy and I don't like spices. So I didn't want to eat. But later I realized that this person is insisting so much, there must be some other reason for it. So I took a few bites so that he is satisfied with it. But later I realized that, okay, this person is from that particular social strata whom nobody likes to invite. Yeah, in fact, I can share another incident from my life. Once in my childhood, there was a Christian man who lived nearby, and I don't exactly, I think he arranged a marriage ceremony of his son. And he invited a Muslim cook. They cooked a rice, a dish of rice biryani, and they wanted to distribute this biryani cooked by a Muslim cook among Muslim neighbors, and nobody accepted that. All the people, I was the only one who accepted that plate. From all other homes, the plates were returned. So that's how we exclude. We need to be very careful, very watchful about our biases. Break the stereotype, don't judge people, value difference of opinion, and watch your words. We are less when we don't include everyone. When everyone is included, everyone wins. Thank you so much for including.